is just taking off now, Rick. Just about air show center.
Confirm that that airplane talks for itself.
And now, still to me, one of the prettier warbirds ever built and designed. That's the F4U Corsair. You ask about anybody what kind of an airplane they'd like to ride in that was a warbird back in the day, and this is the one they're going to select, I'm pretty sure. The P-51 Mustang.
And this is Red Tail.
So this I never verified it, but I was always under the impression that the reason some of these planes sound like they do, they've got a big rotary engine, and as they come past Air Show Center, you're only hearing half of the engine because you can't hear the other half that's away from us.
And that is true to some degree, but it's the tips of the propeller are flying supersonic. So that's where you get the bark.
There it is.
That's what you're hearing.
Like this?
Just like that. Many years ago, that airplane was there on the field. And a lot of them.
Here comes the F4U Corsair and those very unique gull-wing-styled wings. And of course, the beautiful P-51 Mustang. You might want to have your cameras ready, ladies and gentlemen, as the TBM comes across Air Show Center. The bomb bay doors are going to be open.
Again, a page from the past, a piece of history. From the right to the left, we got one more pass coming through. These airplanes don't really need an introduction. They speak for themselves. So I'm going to be quiet. Enjoy.
A little bit of history on the P-51 paint job. Lisa, the red and yellow cowling represents the 302nd Fighter Squadron. The A on the side represents the 99th Fighter Squadron. The yellow banding on the wings represents the 301st Fighter Squadron. And the red fins on the wings represents the 100th Fighter Squadron. That's the markings on the P-51.
From behind, we have got a perfect opportunity. Get those cameras ready. 3, 2, 1. Steps up. Beautiful airplane. And coming in from your right to the left, we have the F4U Corsair and the P-51 Red Tail. This is another photo opportunity, guys. Get those Canon cameras ready. You don't see this very often.
Welcome, everybody. Hope you guys could make it. Beautiful day for an air show.
I couldn't have asked for a better day for a show.
This is so perfect.
Yeah, got some breeze. It's mid-80s. We've got water buffaloes on the field for you, Mr. Tents on the field. If you have an emergency, do visit one of our Red Cross tents. They can assist.
Coming now from the left, south, and north is going to be, again, the P-51 and the F4U Corsair. Again, another good opportunity to take some pictures of some aircraft you will not see very often here.
The F4U Corsair is an American fighter aircraft, saw service primarily in World War II and the Korean War. The Corsair was designed as a carrier-based aircraft, but its difficult carrier landing performance rendered it basically unsuitable and unusable for the Navy until the carrier landing issues were overcome. To accommodate that, they designed the folding wing.
So you talked about the folding wing on the F4U Corsair. It's kind of interesting because they had the issues with having parking space on the aircraft carrier, which is why they designed that. But part of that design, they talked about the retracting the main landing gear, having that actually move rearward as it retracted. But for the type of wing that was chosen, it was difficult to make that landing gear work and the struts long enough to provide that ground clearance. So that's where the inverted gull wing actually came from, was to make accommodations for the landing gear to get seated properly.
Very good, Lauren. So, kids, there's your piece of history for the hour. We're going to kind of feed you history all day today. And the P-51 that you see flying, it's the P-51 Mustang to honor the Tuskegee Airmen. In fact, it's a P-51C. It honors not only the Tuskegee Airmen and the pilots of that famed all-black units, but the support personnel as well. This collective group makes up the Tuskegee Airmen in total. It includes pilots, bombardiers, navigators, ground crews, mechanics, cooks, ambulance drivers, medical staff, and administrative personnel. The Mustang that you see flying, when you can get up close and personal to it, kids, take a look at what's painted on the airplane right underneath the pilot's window. Usually on airplanes during the war, they would put Sierra Sue or Miss Bob, or any, the pilots would name their airplanes. This airplane, when after it was renovated, the pilots, the group decided to put by request under the pilot's window. Now, I'm not gonna tell you why, because I'm going to invite you to Rise Above Trailer. Spend 15 minutes, learn a little bit more about the Tuskegee Airmen and the P-51 and what it takes to keep that airplane flying. And you'll find out why it says by request on the airplane.
While we're waiting for the P-51 to come back across the airfield, please remember that we do have the F-35 simulator drawing. Four spots, four opportunities for you and three other people get inside that F-35 cockpit simulator. That is on till 1 o'clock today. Stop by any souvenir tent. You can drop off a card. They've got them for you there available. You can leave your name and your phone number. And then shortly after 1 o'clock, they'll make a drawing of the four winners, and you'll fly between 4 and 5 today.
All right, coming down air show line in our show cars, we have the Vanguard Squadron. Steve Thompson, we've got Joe, Mark, Dave, you right behind. Folks, if you're on the show line, please give the Vanguards a round of applause as they pass in review. And Steve, congratulations on your birthday. Congratulations on your retirement. We look forward to seeing you on the golf course. Good job, guys. Air Boss is recovering some of our Warbird aircraft and we'll be setting up for our next performance. We have an airliner, I hear it behind me. So again, we have airline arrivals and departures we do need to accommodate. We create a few little delays in the show, but nothing too significant. Next on the list will be Red Tail. The P-51 that you saw flying by has got its own performance. Once.
Well, we have just a few moments here. A quick reminder, if you've just joined us at the airfield, and even those of you that have been here for a while, please remember that we have a beautiful day. Not a whole lot of cloud cover, which is fine, but lots of sunshine and a little bit of wind. But don't be deceived, because the UV doesn't care about the wind or the clouds. So make sure you've got plenty of sunscreen on. Oh, sorry. So when the Corsair comes back, we're going to have an opportunity for us to watch the Corsair actually go through the wing folding procedure. And we'll let you know what's going to happen here in just a few moments.
I think we should count it down. So let's keep an eye on that airplane. Once it gets near the hot static line, which is right by the air, it's right down the show line, and it's on the hard ramp on the South Dakota Air National Guard ramp. The airplane is right in front of us, right behind the Thunderbirds right now, so it should take a minute. And we'll have it in place, and we'll help count down the wing folding. But once we get the Corsair in, we're going to call in Doug Rosendahl in the P-51 Red Tail. So we got a little demonstration that he's going to do for you. Following that, we're going to put the C-17 in the air. That's it. C-17. Lauren, what does... Oh, I've been interrupted. We've got... Ready to count down, kids? Let's go. Five. Count with me. Four. Three. I can't hear you. Two, one, go. Fold. Watch him. Now, an airplane's not supposed to do that, Lauren.
Looks highly unsafe if you forget to put him down.
I think he'd know right away on takeoff.
Probably.
Yeah. But that is neat. If you've never seen that, that is an awesome
picture. That's pretty cool.
Big round of applause for our Warbirds that took to the skies today. And folks, Vanguards have gone down the show line while we get a moment here to remind you there is an autograph tent. That autograph tent is just to the east and south of the announcer stand. The announcer stand's right on runway 927, okay? May not mean much unless you're used to the airfield, but 927 is the one that has the cargo airplanes parked on it, and it's wide, and it looks like a racetrack. You've probably crossed it once or twice if you've been walking around the field here today. So just to the east and south of the announcer stand, we have the autograph tent, and the Vanguards will be there shortly. It's time for a new show. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Lisa Hirsch, and on behalf of over 11,000 members of the Commemorative Air Force, we are pleased to be with you today and to bring you the CAF's P-51C Tuskegee Airmen to the Sioux Falls Power on the Prairie Air Show. The Commemorative Air Force is the largest flying museum in the world with over 165 aircraft, mostly World War II vintage, located at 79 wings and squadrons all across America and around the world. Today we present the P-51 Mustang Tuskegee Airmen. Look high and to your left. You'll see two things about this airplane that are different. It has a razor or a fastback, and it has a red tail. The reason why it has a razorback is because it was an early and very rare version of the famous P-51. But the reason why red tail, it's a longer story. The red-tailed airplanes were flown by the Tuskegee Airmen. The Tuskegee Airmen were part of a program set up by the U.S. Army Air Corps in 1941 that was supposed to prove that black men could not fly fighter aircraft. But they could, and they did. And by doing so, they started the process of the integration of the U.S. military. The U.S. Army Air Corps program to train black men to fly could have been the end of the story. But it became much, much more than that. This is a story about achieving dreams by working hard and focusing on goals. The airmen set out to prove that they could fly and fight, and because of their pursuit of that perfection, they earned a reputation as skilled aviators and fierce fighters as they escorted the heavy bombers over Europe. One of the things that made them different is that the Tuskegee Airmen exercised discipline and stayed with the bombers that they were protecting. Some fighter groups might run off and chase enemy fighters in search of kills, but the airmen did not. Protecting the bombers was their primary mission, and the Tuskegee Airmen did that well. Doing a four-point roll, he's on number three, and here's number four. The point roll demonstrates the precise handling capability of what most regard as one of the greatest fighters of all time. The CAF flies this airplane to honor these great American heroes and to bring their story to audiences across America. Imagine you were a young black man in Detroit or Chicago in the 40s. You wanted to fly and fight for your country. That was not possible then. The flight program at Tuskegee provided that opportunity, and the airmen seized it and pursued their dreams. In doing so, they changed the world. Besides being historic, this airplane is flown to inspire young people to reach for their dreams. Many of the pilots flying in this show today were inspired to fly an airplane just like this, and it changed their lives. One more point roll this time with 8 points, demonstrating the superb handling characteristics of this North American P-51 Mustang. Today's demonstration is being flown by Doug Rosendahl from Clear Lake, Iowa. Doug has over 35 years and 10,000 hours of flight time in over 170 types of aircraft. He's a flight instructor and FAA-designated pilot examiner. The CAF Red Tail Squadron is a dedicated group of volunteers that keep the airplane in tip-top shape. The 51 was the cutting edge of technology in the early 40s, and keeping it running smoothly and safe now requires countless hours of hard work by volunteer staff. The airplane tells the story of the Tuskegee Airmen to the young people of all ages across North America. The CAF Red Tail Squadron also has developed another unique educational tool exhibit called Rise Above. The exhibit looks like a colorful semi-trailer, but it's an expandable on both sides, becomes a 30-seat movie theater with a 180-degree screen. The original film featured in Rise Above Traveling Exhibit is about the Tuskegee Airmen being living proof that perseverance, dedication, and patriotism do in fact lead to success. The foundation of the Rise Above Red Tail Outreach Program is the CAF Red Tail Squadron's 6 guiding principles.
Believe in yourself. Use your brain. Be ready to go. Never quit. And expect to win. I think if you're a mother, use your brain is something you said once or twice. These principles are based on the experiences and successes of the Tuskegee Airmen and play a starring role in the group's outreach efforts. And it doesn't get any better than this. As the Tuskegee Airmen sets up to land, we've called him in for a photo pass. So ladies and gentlemen, get your cameras ready. Look high and to the left. Watch.